Children, in this video, we will learn about bar charts. Bunny started spending a lot of money every month, due to which, by the end of the month, all his money would be over.
Let me start this new year by saving. Every month I will save some money.
Thinking this, Bunny started saving money every month. He would put the money saved in each month in a piggy bank and then write the amount saved in that month in such a table in a notebook. In no time, 6 months passed by.
Oh wow! I've been saving money for 6 months. Now I must have accumulated a lot of money.
Just then, Bhola came to his house. Bunny told him how he had been saving money every month for the past 6 months.
Oh wow, Bunny, this is a very good thing. So, do you now know in which month you saved the least money?
No, how can I find that out, Bhola?
You can find it easily by creating a bar chart, Bunny.
Bar chart? What is that?
Bar charts are a way of displaying information. Let me teach you how to make it.
Bhola drew a vertical line and a horizontal line like this on a paper. Then he wrote the names of the 6 months on the horizontal line in this way. Then, in order to determine the interval between the two numbers on the vertical line or the scale of the chart, he found the largest number in Bunny's table, 30. So, he wrote down the numbers from 1 to 30 equally spaced on the vertical line.
Bunny, can you look in your table and tell me how much money you saved in the month of January?
20 rupees.
Bhola now made a thin rectangle over the month of January, whose length was going up to the number 20 written on the vertical line.
Look, Bunny, we have to make thin rectangles in this way on the horizontal line for the amount saved in each month, whose length will be the same as the amount saved in that month. And because these rectangles look like bars, hence we call this chart a bar chart.
Oh wow, this is very interesting. Now I will make a rectangle with a height reaching number 18 in this way for the amount saved in February.
Bunny and Bhola together made rectangles in this way for all months.
Bunny, look, our bar chart is ready. Here, the height of each bar shows you the amount saved in that month. And as you can see, the bars in the bar chart are rectangles of exactly the same width and the space between them is also equal. On the vertical line, I have written equally spaced numbers from 1 to 30 to show the amount you have saved. And on the horizontal line, I have written the names of the months. Now, can you tell me in which month you have saved the least amount of money?
Absolutely, Bhola. Now it has become very easy. The month of May has the smallest rectangle, which means I saved the least money, 16 rupees, in the month of May. And look, The month of April has the longest rectangle. That means I save the most money, 30 rupees, in the month of April. Well done, Bunny. You learned very quickly. Now, just like this, you continue saving money so that by the end of the year, you can accumulate a lot of money.
Bunny promised Bhola that he would continue to save money. Children, in this video, we learned about bar charts. In the next video, we will learn more about it through some interesting examples.